Hello, everybody, and welcome to another installment of Tech Tuesday. I know it has been a moment since I've done one of these, but I am back. Today, I want to talk to you about some of the gear that I use on the various projects that I've been involved with and just show you my kit. The biggest thing that I want to point out is you don't have to have the same kit as me. In many ways, what I have is overkill. And I don't use a lot of the elements that are in this. I only use a couple of pieces, and there, a lot of the pieces in this I use from time to time, and they're nice to have. But that doesn't mean that you need the same things. You can get by with a much more minimalist kit and still produce great videos and photos. So first of all, I want to talk about this pack here. This is a Burton snowboard backpack that I picked up on a job in Florida almost 7 years ago. And this has been my go-to pack over the years. It has been something that I use on a very consistent basis to transport my gear. It can fit almost anything in it. It has a lot of pockets. It has a lot of room for just putting my gear and going out the door. I've tried a number of different backpacks. However, this one right here is my go-to. I can go anywhere with it. It's been across the country with me, and this is the bag that I use 90% of the time when I'm transporting a lot of gear. In this bag, I have most of my entire kit. It opens from the back, so it does protect your gear. You got a lot of pockets here, and yeah, it's really deep, and I can fit a lot of stuff in it. Normally, my GH4 and Tokina would live in here, but I'm currently shooting with it. I'll try and show it in a minute. So it can fit a number of lenses and other peripheral devices that you might need to make visuals come to life. One of my favorite lenses that I use on a very consistent basis is this Canon 24-105. I've used this lens a lot. What I really like about this lens is it has image stabilization, so I can run around without a tripod and still get somewhat usable shots. It still does have a handheld look to it, but it's not jittery. I also like the range of this lens. Being an F4 and attaching it to a MetaBones adapter, I can get typically a full stop of light out of it, more than what it is intended on the lens. So I believe this F4 will become a 2.8, which is pretty nice. I can get a lot more out of that lens. I also have a piece of shit 70 to 300 zoom lens. I've had this a very long time. I don't use it, to be honest. The only time I would use it is if I really need that long shot, but it's a 4-5.6. I rarely use this lens, but it still lives in my bag. I also got the Nifty 50, the Canon 50mm 1.8. Once again, it's nice for low light situations. However, I wish this lens was image stabilized. This right here, my MetaBones adapter, that's the lifeblood in many ways in terms of the ability to connect Canon lenses. Without that, I'd probably be shooting on Lumix lenses and Olympus lenses. The MetaBones adapter allows me to connect almost any lens. For me, I decided to go with Canon mount lenses because I had no idea of how long I was gonna be on a GH4. I know that at some point I'm gonna wanna transition to maybe a larger camera system, be that a C100, C200, C300, RED, Panasonic EVO 1. But with all that in mind, I knew that the variable that really wouldn't change too much was gonna be my lenses. This is my Marshall monitor. Once again, this is another piece of gear that I rarely use. It still lives in my kit because there are shots where I want to get really detail oriented and really look at my frame. And it's nice to have a bigger monitor as opposed to the little LCD that is on the back of my screen. Here's a shotgun microphone that I rarely use. I'm typically using my onboard microphone. that I can plug into the mini jack on the side of my camera. However, this is still a nice microphone to have, even though I rarely use it. LED light, it's nice to have one of these. Just something small that I can throw on top of the camera if I'm in a dark circumstance and I need that little extra punch of light. This is my audio bag. What I like about this is if I'm going through customs or if I'm going through security, I can quickly pull this out. They can quickly look at it. We don't have to unzip things. We don't have to pull things out like I normally would have to do with this big bag here. That is all alleviated very quickly. They can just look at it and move me through. Zoom H4N, I've used this so much. I've used this on my podcast. I've used this on shoots. This has been really nice to just pick up really clean, fresh sounding audio. My main go-to microphone, which is currently living on this cage, is my Rode Video Go mic. It's the cheaper of the Rode microphones. However, at the same time, it's worked really well. What I like about it is I don't need batteries. I can just plug straight in to the mini phone jack on the side with this little mini jack. So that is my main little shotgun that I use. ND filters, I got a 72 and a 77. It sucks to leave these at home. Really sucks, because then you have to crank your f-stop to like f-16, f-22, and mess with your shutter speed. That's happened before. I was in San Diego, left these at home. Really sucked. This is my Think Tank card wallet. Goes everywhere with me. Has a Velcro to store all my SD cards. What I like about this is it Velcros and you will not lose a card. Black Rapids strap. This is probably my favorite camera strap I've used. It's a nice little sling. You don't have to wear it around your neck like a tourist. It just pulls and goes. And then the final thing I really want to point out is just the camera bags that I've used. I've tried a number of different camera bags. However, this one is probably my favorite day-to-day bag. It's not ideal for all circumstances, but it will get the job done. I also have this Think Tank bag. This is a nice day-to-day bag where I can just take stuff around. It has this inside of it for a ton of different peripherals that might be loose and you want to put in a pouch. This is my Tamarack day bag. I use it for like hikes, just going around town with my camera. It's decent, it's a little small. You can only fit a couple of lenses in it, but it definitely gets the job done and it was a decent investment. And finally, this is my Canon bag that came with a Canon 60D, which I sold a long time ago. This here, I do not use this at all. I should probably just sell it. But what is nice about it is I can make it a dedicated audio bag and I can store other peripheral devices inside of it to just put stuff away and use it as just another bag at my disposal. So that's basically my camera package. That's all the time I have for this episode. If you have thoughts and opinions, leave them in the comments below. I'd love to learn more about the gear that you're using to make different films and photos. But as always, create, share, and sustain the life that you want. Get out there and make some awesome work, guys. Thanks.